Cecilia Barbara Atim Ogwal joined Parliament in 1985, first as a Constituent Assembly delegate from 1985 to 1993, and later an MP from 1996 to 2024. The opposition strongwoman, nicknamed the Iron Lady, piqued interest in politics at the young age of 12 while in Senior 1 at Sacred Heart in Gulu in 1961.
Speaker, you are young. God forbid, if your wife were to leave, let's just pray it will not happen. I'm giving example. Young as you are, or my son David here, the wife decide to go, and we wait for 20 years or 30 years, and say, now give us your accountability. You will hear, he married this one, then left two children, then I.
Ogwal became involved in Ugandan politics, serving as the acting Secretary General of the Uganda People's Congress from 1985 to 1992. She was part of the Constituent Assembly, which drafted and promulgated the 1995 Ugandan Constitution. During the 2006 parliamentary elections, the deceased veteran opposition politician lost her Lira municipality seat to Jimmy Akena, the son of the UPC founder and former president Apollo Milton Obote. In 2011, Ogwal contested and won the woman representative seat for the newly created Dokolo district under the Forum for Democratic Change ticket, a position she held until the time of her demise on the 18th of January 2024, in what is widely seen as the end of an era. Nelson Saddam Abili, one of the campaign agents of the late Cecilia Ogwal, says the late MP served long in Parliament because of her unique character.
Generally, she was a trained politician, a person who could know where she was going. And if I can summarize, she was a leader who loved our people, who could unite them. She was neutral.
Being vocal and brave on land matters also earned the late Cecilia more time in Parliament, as Patrick Onyum Okwang says. He is a journalist and political analyst.
When government of Uganda by then came with a proposal in the government white paper, the proposal that the it should be the government to manage the land in Uganda. And she was among the few members of parliament by then who rejected the idea. And in the end, it was resolved in parliament that the land should belong now to the citizens.
Jimmy Wuru, an NRM supporter, says Cecilia Ogwal lasted long in parliament because she was God-fearing and a law-abiding leader.
Imat was a good person, and she was a God-fearing person, and she was somebody who respect the law of the government.
Cecilia Atim Ogwal beat the odds to remain in parliament because of her struggle to fight for women's rights, according to Agnes Linda Auma, the Lira District Woman MP.
An extraordinary woman. A fearless woman, a risk taker, a God-given woman, undefeatable, courageous in all ways, but at the same time, humble, good-hearted, a good listener, and a mother.
The late Cecilia Ogwal, who was 77 years of age by the time of her demise, was survived by a husband, Lamek Ogwal, who she fondly referred to as Mr. Smart, and seven children. She will be laid to rest in Alito sub-county in Kole District. Report by Solomon Okabo for the news.